A very good morning to you all, my dear students. I hope you all very happy and safe. Have you finished your homework? Okay, fine. Now I will show your homework review. Just verify your answer. Okay? Okay, have you finished your homework? Just you verify your answer. Okay? Now first question. Find the HCF of 3,960, 4,455, and 2,970, isn't it? Now we can do in cross division method. Step 1, only one time, isn't it? 3,960, remainder 495. Again, step 2, 495 6 times, 2,970. What's the HCF of 3,960 and 4,455? 495. Now we can find the HCF of 2,970 and 495. This is step 3. We can divide 6 times. We'll get remainder 0. So, HCF of 3,960 and 4,455, 2,970 is 495. Okay. Are you clear? Okay. Then next question, find the LCM of 840, 630, 945 and 378. Now we can do in two table, isn't it? We can do in two table 420 up to the all prime factors will get, isn't it? Now we can multiply the product of all prime factors, isn't it? We'll get 7560. Are you clear? Okay, today we are going to learn about relationship between HCF and LCM. Okay, relationship between HCF and LCM. Now, the product of the HCF and the LCM of two natural numbers, that is N1 and N2. Okay, now we can write HCF into LCM equal to N1 into N2. That is the two numbers, natural numbers. Now we want to find N1, means N1 is equal to HCF into LCM by N2. Otherwise, one number is equal to HCF into LCM divided by another number. Now we want to find HCF, means HCF is equal to N1 into N2. We can multiply the two numbers divided by LCM. Okay. Now, LCM is equal to N1 into N2 by HCF. The product of two numbers divided by HCF. Okay, this is the relationship between HCF and LCM. Okay, now we can do some problems on the board. Okay.
The greatest number that divides 2,838, 4,053 and 4,458, leaving exactly 3 as remainder in each case. Okay. Now we want to find out the GCD or HCF. Here leaving exactly 3 as remainder. Want to leave the exactly 3 as remainder. So we can subtract from these numbers. Okay. So we can write, if suppose if we subtract the remainder from the numbers 2000 for 838 minus 3. That remainders we want to subtract from these numbers. Okay. So we can subtract 2838 minus 3 is equal to 2835. Then next number 4053 minus 3 is equal to 4050. Then last number 4458 is equal minus 3 is equal to 4455. Okay, now we can do any one method. Already we learn about what? Two methods. What are the methods? First one is prime factorization method. Second one is cross division methods, isn't it? For HCF. Now we can use prime factorization method. Okay, now first one is 2835. Now, two table, isn't it? 1, 2 is 2, 4, 2 are 8, 1, 2 is, sorry, this is odd number, so we can't do in two table. So, we can write in three table. 9 threes are 27. 1 balance. 4 threes are 12. 5 threes are 15. Now 3 tables. 3 threes are 9. 1 3 is 3. 5 threes are 15. Again 3 table. 1 3 is 3. 0. Because this one is not in 3 table. So we can take together 15. 5 threes are 15. Then 3 table. 3 threes are 9. 1 balance. 5 threes are 15. Then 5 table. 7 fives are 35, then 7 table 1. Okay, now 4050. 2 table, 2 twos are 4, 0, 2 twos are 4, 1 balance, 5 twos are 10. Then 3 table, 7, 6 threes are 18, isn't it? 6 threes are 18, 2 balance, 22. 7 threes are 21. Again 1 balance 15. 5 threes are 15. Now 3 table. 2 threes are 6. Again 2 threes are 6. 5 threes are 15. Then 3 table. 7 threes are 21. 5 threes are 15. Then 3 table. 2 threes are 6. 5 threes are 15. Then 5 table. 5 fives are 25. Again 5 table 1. Okay. Then next 4455. This is in 3 table. 1 3 is 3. 1 balance 14. 4 threes are 12. 2 balance 25. 8 threes are 24. 1 balance 15. 5 threes are 15. Okay. Now again 3 table, 4 threes are 12, 2 balance 28, 9 threes are 27, 1 balance, 5 threes are 15. Okay, then again 3 table, 1 3 is 3, 1 balance, 6 threes are 18, 5 threes are 15. Again 3 table, 5 threes are 15, 1 balance 15, 5 threes are 15. Then 3 table is not, now 5 table 11, 11 fives are 55, then 11 table 1. Okay, now we can write 2835 is equal to how many, what are the factors, prime factors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times 3, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, then 5 into 7, isn't it? 5 into 7. Now, 4050 is equal to, 50 is equal to, only 1 time 2, then 1, 2, 3, 4 times 3. 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, then 5 into 5. Okay? 5 into 5. Then, 4455 is equal to 3, 4 times 3 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 11. Now we can find out the common prime factors, isn't it? Common prime factors. This 3 is common. Then here these 3's are common. Here also these 3's are common. Now here this 3, second one, this 3 and 3 common. Then, any common number is here? No, isn't it? Yes. Now we can write that therefore, the product of the prime factors product of the prime factors. What are the prime factors? So here 5 also common, isn't it? Here 5 also common. Now here, what are the common prime factors? 3 into this 3. Then 3 into 3 into 3, isn't it? 4 times 3 into 3. Then 1 time 5 is equal to 3 threes are 9. 9 threes are 27. 27 into 3, 81. 81 into 5, 8 fives are, 1 into 5, 5, 8 fives are 40. So this answer is 405. What the HCF of 2835, 4050 and 4455 is 405. Thus 405 is divides. Okay, therefore thus we can write, thus 405 divides 2838, then 4053 and 4458, leaving exactly 3 as remainder. Okay, leaving exactly 3 as remainder. Okay, thus 405 divides 2838, 4053 and 4458, leaving exactly 3 as remainder. Are you clear? Okay, now next question. Now second question, find the greatest number that divides 5461, 5882 and 6303, leaving exactly 1, 2 and 3 as remainder respectively. Now we can subtract from these numbers. What are the remainders? 1, 2, 3 remainder respectively. First one is remainder 5461. What's the remainder? 1. Okay. Now second number is remainder is 2. Then third number remainder is 3. Okay. Now if we subtract the remainder from the numbers, we have 5461 minus 1 is equal to 5460. Isn't it? Then second number 5882 minus 2 is equal to 5880. Then third one 6303 minus 3 is equal to 6300. Okay. Now we can find the HCF of five thousand four hundred and sixty, five thousand eight hundred and eighty, and six thousand three hundred. Now we can find the HCF. HCF have two methods, isn't it? Prime factorization method and cross division method. First question, we have used prime factorization method, isn't it? Okay. Today this question, now this question, we can use the cross division method. Okay. Now cross division method means we can write the step by step. First step, find the HCF of first two numbers, 5460 and 5880. Okay. Now 5000, which is the greatest number? 5880 divided by 5460. Isn't it? 5460. Only one time. 5460. 0 minus 0? 0. 8 minus 6 is 2. 8 minus 4 is 5 minus 5, 0. Then step 2, isn't it? Step 2, now we have these two, compare these two, divide 5460 divided by 420, isn't it? So, which is the greater? 5460 divided by 420, remainder is divided. Are you clear? Okay. Now here, 420 into 13, 1012 is to 4, isn't it? 0, 6, 4, 5. So we can write 13 times 5416. So therefore the HCF of 5416 is 5,580 and 5,460 is what? 420. Okay, 420. Now we can find the HCF of, that is the step 3. Find the HCF of 420 and which is the third number? 6,300. 6,300. Now we can write 6,300 divided by 420. 420 the 13 times 5,460. So we can multiply by 15, 0, 0, 21, 0, 2, 4. Did you catch? Yes. 6,300. How many times? 15 times. So what's the HCF of therefore? The HCF of these three numbers. 5,460, 5,880 and 6,300, isn't it? 6,300 is, what is the HCF? 420. So we can write thus 420 divides 5,461, 5,882 and 6,303, leaving exactly 1, 2 and 3 as remainder. Okay, 3 as remainder. Are you clear? Okay, this is the answer. What's the HCF? 420. Thus, we can write, last step we can write, thus, okay, now I write here, thus, 5,420 is, okay, 420 is divides 5,482 and 6,303, leaving exactly 1, 2 and 3 as remainder. Okay. Leaving exactly 1, 2 and 3 as remainder. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. As remainder. Okay. That's all. Are you clear? This is the answer. Okay. Question number 3. What is the smallest 6-digit number that is exactly divisible by 48 and 108. This is, what is the smallest 6-digit? Yes, smallest. If you want to find the smallest 6-digit number, so we can find out the LCM. Greatest means GCD or HCF. Yes, smallest. So we can find out LCM. LCM of 48 and 108. Isn't it? Before, here, which is the smallest 6-digit number? Smallest 6-digit number is, what? 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, isn't it? Lakh. 1 lakh, isn't it? 1 lakh is the smallest 6-digit number. Okay. Now we can find out LCM of 48 and 108. LCM of 48 and 108. Now we can do this down method. 2 table. Now 2 to 4, 4 to 8. 5 to 10. 4 to 8. Again 2 table. 1 2 is 2. 2 to 4. Then here 27 is not in 2 tables. 2 to 4. 7 to 14. Now here 3 table. 4 3 12. 9 3 27. 2 table. 2 to 4. Here 9 is not in 2 table. Then again 2 table. 1 2 is 2. Here 9. Then 3 table. 3 3 9. 3 table. 1 3 is 3. Now we can product, we can multiply all prime factors. Okay, now we can multiply all prime factors. 2 into 2 into 3 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. We can multiply 432. 2 2 are 4, 4 2 are 8, 8 2 are 16. 16 into, then again multiply by 3. 3 3 are 9, 9 3 are 27. We can multiply will get what's the LCM? 432. So we get LCM of 48 and 108 is 432. Okay. Now, on dividing 1 lakh by 432, what is the LCM? Just you divide 6 digit number divided by 432. Now we can divide 1 lakh divided by 432. Okay. Now here divide 2 times 864, subtract 136. We can take from here 1 0. Now here 3 times 1296. Okay, 1296. Then next 1 time 1 into 432 is equal to 432. Now what's the remainder? 208. Okay, 208. So now we'll get the ghost quotient is 231. On dividing 1 lakh by 432, we get 231 as quotient, 208 as remainder. What's the remainder? 208. Are you clear? Okay. Now 432 into 231. What is the quotient is 231. We can multiply the quotient by 432. This LCM into this quotient. Okay. Now we can multiply 432 into 231. If you multiply, means we'll get 99,792. We need, which is the smallest 6 digit number, but this is 5 digit number, isn't it? First, this LCM into quotient is equal to, we'll get 5 digit number. We need 6 digit number, so we can multiply by next number. What is the quotient? 231. What is the next number? 232. Okay, we need 6 digit number, so we can multiply by 432 into 232. Now we can multiply, here we'll get 1,224. This is the 6 digit number. So 1,224 is the smallest 6 digit number that is exactly divisible by 48 and 108. Okay, that is exactly divisible by 48 and 108. Suppose you multiply by 231, we'll get 6 digit number, means we can multiply before number. That is the smallest 6 digit number, means we can take that number. But here you multiply by quotient 231, we'll get 5 digit number, isn't it? So we can multiply by next number. Are you clear? Okay. Now, between HCF and LCM, okay? Relationship between HCF and LCM. The product of the HCF and the LCM of two natural numbers. Product of HCF and LCM is equal to two natural numbers, that is N1 and N2 is same as the product of N1 and N2. N1 into N2, okay? As the HCF of two coprime number is 1, their LCM is equal to their product. This LCM is equal to their product. Any two coprime number, that is 1, that LCM is equal to the product. Okay. Now HCF and the LCM is equal to N1 into N2. Now we can find what is HCF. HCF is equal to N1 into N2 by N1 into N2 by this LCM is going that side, that is division. Multiplication is going that side, division. So LCM. Are you clear? Then how to find out LCM? LCM is equal to N1 into N2, N1 into N2 divided by HCF. Okay? Are you clear? HCF. This is the first one. This is second one. Then, third one. What is N1? N1 is equal to, N1 equal to HCF into LCM. HCF into LCM by N2. Okay? N2 will come division. Okay? N2. Now, fourth one. L2 is equal to HCF into LCM divided by N1. Okay, this is the formula. We can use this formula and do the problems. Okay, are you clear? Now, question number 4. The HCF of two numbers is 240, while their LCM of 1440. If one of the numbers is 720, find the other number. Okay, now we want to find out N2, isn't it? One number is, now here HCF is equal to 240, then LCM is equal to 1440, therefore here N1 is equal to 720, this is given. Now N2, we want to find out N2. Now here N2 is equal to HCF into LCM divided by N1. Now we can write 240 into 1440 divided by 720, isn't it? Now here 720, 0, 0 cancel, 2 table, 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 7 2s are 14, 2 2s are 4. Now here 1 2 is 2, 8 2s are 16, 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 1 18 is 18, 2 18s are 36. Now we get 240 into 2 is equal to, what's the answer? Answer is 240 into 2. Okay, 4 2s are 8, 2 2s are 480. Therefore, N2 is equal to, N2 is equal to 480. This is the answer. N2 is equal to 480 is the answer. Okay, then one more question. The LCM of two co-prime numbers is 1120. Okay, HCF of any two co-prime number is 1, that LCM is the same as the product of the numbers. Already we learned, isn't it? Second point. Just you recall that second point, okay? Now here, HCF is 1, that LCM of the two co-prime number is 1120. So, 1 into 1120 is equal to 1120 into equal to, what is the, one of the number is 32. So, N1 is equal to 32 into N2. Now we want to find out N2. Okay. N2 is equal to 1120 divided by 32. 1120 divided by 32. Now we can simplify. 2 table. 1 2 is 2. 6 2 is 12. 5 2 is 10. 6 2 is 12. 0. Then 8 2 is 16. 2 2 is 4. 8 2 is 16. 0. Then 4 2s are 8, 1 2 is 2, 4 2s are 8, 0. Now here 2 2s are 4, 7 2s are 14, 0. 1 2 is 2, 3 2s are 6, 1 balance 5. Okay. Therefore, N2 is equal to 35. So that next number is N2. That N2 is, N2 value of N2 is equal to 35. Are you clear? Okay. Today's homework, book page number 34, revision exercise. Okay, not exercise, this is the revision exercise. Question number 7. Okay, question number 7. Only one problem. Okay, home. Okay, we can see next class. Thank you.